Hi everyone, my name is Richard Rejino, and I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about my musical career and also how MTNA has always been a part of it. My journey to music was really as unlikely as it was very direct, and by that I mean that I grew up on a farm in West Texas, and the largest community within in the region was about 30 miles away, so we were very isolated. You wouldn't think there was music in our house, but I had a mother who loved music. She loved to sing and could harmonize, and we had a piano in the house, and she played a little piano by ear. I remember seeing the piano in our living room, and I went up to it when I was about 7 or 8 years old, and I remember playing those first few notes, and I started making up words, matching the pitches I was hearing and singing. Thankfully, when I turned 10 years old, my parents were able to provide lessons for me, and that's when I started. And I remember by the time I reached the seventh grade that I knew I was going to major in music. I knew what college I was going to go to. I knew what professor I was going to study with. And all of that happened. And when I finished my undergraduate degree, I went to the University of North Texas to work on my master's. And did that, and about a semester before I was to end my graduate studies, I had the enlightenment that, you know, school was going to be over and I had to make a living. So, and I wasn't going to go back to the farm. So luckily, my teacher at North Texas knew of a person who oversaw group piano classes in the Dallas public school system. And she gave me my first job. And so I taught at a school, an elementary school, class piano. I also started teaching at home and a few private lessons here and there. Then I married a very wonderful woman who you all know, Mona Rejino, and we bought a house and opened up a private piano studio. And it was then that we first came in contact with MTNA. We joined the national group. And of course, locally, we were charter members of the Carrollton Music Teachers, and we were very active, made many, many good friends, and many of those friends are still part of our lives today. Also at that time, I was working at Brook Mays Music Company. I worked in their sheet music department, and it was there that I really fell in love with music retail. I learned so much from interacting with the teachers that would come in. They told me all of their problems, all of their successes, and I learned a lot about piano repertoire, teaching literature. I was able to use my knowledge about classical music that I'd gained in college, and I loved getting the new music and playing through. And so I started a newsletter and put in music reviews of the new pieces. So it was a great outlet for me creatively as well as musically. And then a few years later, my boss retired, and so I and a partner bought Brook Mays Print Music Division and had our own business. And it eventually grew to 17 locations. As part of that, we always looked for opportunities to grow the business, and it was then that I started displaying at the national convention with MTNA, and that was also a very pivotal point in my career. I met so many teachers from across the country. I met so many publishers and composers, and just built up a great community of contacts and support. That again, many of those relationships I still have today and cherish them very much. All of this is to say that for me, MTNA has been a partner in my life. They've helped me when I was starting, and they continue to be a part of my life, helping me to develop as a person, as a musician, and as a music businessman. And all through this time, they've been there in some shape, in some form. Even today, I'm working in the nonprofit world now as executive director for the Retail Print Music Dealers Association, as well as the National Piano Foundation. And I work with MTNA to further the recreational music making movement. They have always been there for me. And if you're thinking about MTNA or joining MTNA, I urge you to do that, because they are, as I said, a partner, someone who will always be there and has many resources. Wherever you go across the country, you know there'll always be an MTNA teacher that you can find. I want to thank again MTNA for giving me this wonderful opportunity to tell you a little bit about my story and to tell you how much I love and appreciate the Music Teachers National Association. Thank you.